Hi beautiful souls, my name is Monica and I help people master their awakening journey. In this video, I share with you a powerful way how you can spot your own self-sabotage that might be creating a negative reality in your life. With a bit of a story. I have a friend who is very well established, financially secure. He has worked incredibly hard all of his life and got to a point where he doesn't have to work, where he is very financially secure. Now, he has spent a few years traveling around the US and Australia and New Zealand and a few other places. And we have recently met and sort of spoken about this thing in his life where, you know, he announced on Facebook that he's actually going back to work. And I was incredibly shocked to see why would somebody like him who, you know, can do anything in life would want to go back to the corporate environment and work for a boss. Now, we've had a pretty in-depth discussion about this because for me, you know, I would just love to have all the time to just be able to do, you know, only what I want, travel the world and not ever having to worry about money. But I'm not quite there yet. Whereas, you know, I look at Jim and he is already there living the dream but wants to go back to work, and this basically got us talking about the whole subject of having something meaningful to do in your life, you know, knowing your purpose and truly following your passion. And you know, when we discussed the whole subject of purpose with Jim, he was very adamant that he doesn't have a clue what that is. He doesn't know which way to go, doesn't have any passion. And something happened in his life when his mom got ill, and he basically straight away fell into the fear mode, like what if he will need to. He panicked. And he straight away applied for a job, and obviously with his experience and education and you know, years of successful stories, he was able to secure a job pretty quickly. But and he's got a few weeks before he needs to go back to work. But what actually transpired through our conversation is that he's not particularly excited about going back to work. And he actually started to think that he may have sabotaged himself. So as we started exploring the whole self-sabotage, it became very obvious to me that he, the minute he has heard about his mom's illness, he fell into fear. And the fear is very much driven by ego or reactive ego mind that wants to take an action immediately, because whenever we feel fear, there is a tremendous amount of tension sitting in our body. And we don't like that. We want to push we want to resolve the tension and push it away as quickly as possible. And we often end up taking action that may not be aligned with our highest good, that is coming from fear, lack, scarcity mentality. And that action may feel good for a very short period of time, but it actually, the good feeling evaporates pretty quickly, because then you realize the consequences of the action and you start to see how you may have self-sabotaged yourself. So and this is a perfect example how to spot our own self-sabotaging behaviors and how our own mind can sometimes trick us into taking a quick reactive action instead of a considered, intended action that comes from the heart and our higher self. So in this video, I want to share with you a quick method how you can observe your own patterns and habits and the kind of actions you're taking and really assess whether those actions stem from true love, passion, joy, and freedom, you know, your highest values, or whether the actions were driven purely by fear, scarcity, lack mentality, and so on and so forth. So whenever there is the presence of fear, scarcity, it often comes from lack of trust and our ego interfering, wanting to give us the false sense of security and safety that obviously doesn't last and doesn't fulfill us emotionally. What I have been doing instead, whenever I'm triggered by something or I feel fearful, I don't feel safe, or I have a situation happen in my own life where I have a decision to make, and the decision can be between love and fear, you know, something I truly love and value and would love to do, or something, you know, that I believe I have to do in order to feel safe and secure. And this area of have to do not only stems from more ego or controlling reactive mind, but it also often stems from having limiting and negative core beliefs in place that actually inform those decisions and drive our actions. So if we want to experience a better reality, then we need to really simply look at our own lives. You know, what is physically visible in our own life that represents scarcity, that represents lack of mentality and a fear mentality? And it could be the kind of job, you know, that we do. It could be the partner we are with. It could be anything else, the home we live in, the country we live in, how we live, the kind of friends we surround ourselves with. Everything you do and have and are in your own life is a result of what you think about yourself, others, and the world. And these three levels of perception are basically creating your reality. So step one is pretty much observe the physical reality and any scarcity, lack sort of physical reality that is showing up for you. That takes you back through to your limiting and core belief. And once you are aware of that, you can reprogram them. You can ask yourself a very powerful question. What fears have driven the decision for me to take this action? So for example, in case of Jim, he has asked himself the question, you know, what fears have driven him to take the decision to apply for a job that he actually doesn't want to do? He's not passionate about it. He only took the decision based on lack, fear, and scarcity mentality, thinking that maybe there will be bills that he will have to pay in the future. And even though he is actually financially very secure, he started imagining things that haven't even happened yet that could potentially go wrong, and he wanted to prepare for that. And while I believe in preparation and, you know, planning ahead and all that, but if you are thinking negatively, if you are imagining things, imagination is part of the creative process. And whatever you put out into the universe comes back to you. So be very careful about what you're sending out into the universe, what you're imagining, because that kind of reality then transpires in the physical form. So we all know that everything starts with a thought, that every single physical reality or an object ever created always started with a thought, with a mental thought. So, and as the law of attraction confirms, thoughts become things. So be very aware of what you're sending out into the universe. And the last piece of advice that I want to give you in this video is to, whenever you're experiencing these reactive situations where you have to make a decision between love and trust often, or the fear. So in Jim's case, do I continue to do what I love and trust that my mom will be healthy and okay, and no matter what happens, we will be safe and provided for, and you know, we will be able to find a solution to cover any expenses and stuff like that. You know, there is the love and trust and safety, or there is the lack, scarcity, fear mentality, and both inform our decision making. So whenever you feel that you have to make a decision, what I want you to do is to get out of your thinking mind and sink into your body and really connect with your heart. You can even put your hand on your heart, because the HeartMath Institute confirms that our heart is electromagnetically 1,000 times stronger than our brain. And therefore, whenever you are experiencing a situation where you have to make this tough decision between love, trust, joy, passion, or fear, then I want you to sink into your body and connect with your higher self and really observe yourself as if though you're looking at yourself from a much higher perspective, to examine how you are feeling, what you're thinking, what you are considering to do, what actions you're considering to do, and whether those actions actually are aligned with your highest good, passion, love, and joy, or whether those actions actually stem from fear, lack, and scarcity mentality. And then once you sink in, your higher self will always inform you through intuition, through heart knowing, through deep calling, and just knowing what the next best step for you is to take. The thing you have to really work on developing and building is this connection between yourself and your higher self, your heart. Because what a lot of us do, they stay in our minds, and we know that our mind represents duality. Even our brain has a right, left hemisphere and the right hemisphere. And the duality is very much about right and wrong, good or bad. So all decisions, or true decisions that represent the highest passion, joy, fulfillment, and freedom will never be found in our conscious mind. They will always be found in your heart, that is very closely linked to your higher self. So just to summarize, if you are experiencing a negative reality in your life, then I would like to invite you to observe yourself from a higher perspective. Look at your reality, the negative reality that you are creating. And that will inform you of the negative limiting and core beliefs that you actually have in your subconscious mind. Then you can reprogram them and expand yourself to welcome the opposite into your life. So that's the first step, number one. Observe your reality and work backwards to identify your core and negative limiting beliefs. Secondly, I want you to sink from your thinking mind into your feeling heart and connect with your higher self. Your higher self holds all the answers about your next best step in your journey. And it is the unity consciousness. The heart represents the single most fulfilling type of guidance that you can ever get in your life. And the more you learn to connect to it, the more fulfilled you will become in your own life. So these are a few simple steps how you can start noticing whether you are sabotaging yourself in your life, whether you are making decisions from the heart in line with your higher self, in line with your highest joy, passion, freedom, or whether the decisions you taking that then result in the negative reality actually come from the lack, scarcity, and limited type of mindset that is fear-based. So here are a few tips from me on how to identify self-sabotage in your own life. And if you are somebody who is going through an awakening journey, or who is very interested in personal development, growth, spirituality, law of attraction, then I invite you to subscribe to my channel, as I will be sharing so many more videos, including interviews and free healing tools to help you in your ascension journey. So if you have identified any self-sabotage in your own life and have an interesting way of going about it, any interesting healing tools, please comment below to let everybody else in our community know, so that we can continue to share and learn from each other. I'm really passionate about creating a community of people who are hungry to ascend, to heal, to integrate their shadow side and can start to operate from their higher self, from their heart. Because when we get to this place of our evolution, this is where manifestations are super fast and super easy. This is where we are in a flow of joy, passion, abundance. This is where we attract people and experiences that reflect to us, or in a state of harmony, joy, and bliss. And it's a beautiful way of living. So I would like to invite you to connect with me, subscribe to this channel, and join our community so that we can continue to learn from each other and support each other in our ascension journey. I'm sending you so much love, peace, and joy, and I look forward to seeing you in another video. Namaste.